Hello all, welcome back to my channel. In this video I'll be explaining you about classification of rocks. This topic is a part of stone as a building material in the subject BMCP, which is building materials and construction planning. Okay, so coming to the classification of rocks, generally we have three classification. One is geological classification, physical classification and chemical classification. Now let's get into detail what is all this classification about and what is the sub classification of it, what are the different types of stones, examples of this type of classification, everything etc. we shall see. Coming to the geological classification. In geological classification, rocks are generally classified into three types: igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic rocks. Igneous rocks are nothing but those rocks which are formed by the cooling of magma. And sedimentary rocks are those rocks which place somewhere else from their place of origin. Metamorphic rocks. Metamorphic rocks could be either an igneous rock or a sedimentary rock which has changed its character or changed its composition due to heat, pressure, stress, etc. Okay. And igneous rocks are further classified into three types, which is plutonic, hyperbasalt, and volcanic rocks. Next, sedimentary rocks are again classified into four types or subdivided into four types: residual, sedimentary, chemical and organic. Metamorphic rocks are also classified into four types, which is thermal, cataclastic, dynamothermal and plutonic rocks. So now let's get into detail what is the subdivision, how we can define the subdivision and what are the examples we will see. Coming to the first one, geological classification. I told you geological classification, the first classification of rocks is igneous rocks. So what are igneous rocks? Igneous rocks are those which are formed by the cooling of magma. Okay, you know what is magma, right? Magma is nothing but you know, lava, right? You have seen lava will generally flow out from the volcanic eruption. When this lava is inside the earth's surface, it is called as magma. So lava can be defined as magma minus volatile gases. So when this magma is inside the earth's surface, it is also having some volatile gases with it. But once when it comes over the earth's surface, these volatile gases escape into the atmosphere. So at that time, we will be calling it as lava. So lava is nothing but simply magma minus volatile gases. So these igneous rocks are further classified into three types. I have shown you plutonic, hyperbasalt and volcanic. So let's see how the cooling of magma is taking place and how we are defining the names as plutonic, hyperbasalt and volcanic. Let's see now. So the first classification, what I've told you in igneous, is plutonic rocks. Plutonic rocks are those which are formed due to the cooling of magma only, but at considerable depth from the earth's surface. What is the meaning of this? Means suppose if this is your earth surface, relatively at a lesser depth, means not so deeper from the earth's surface, relatively at lesser depth or some considerable depth, if this cooling of the magma takes place and if rocks are formed by this cooling, then those are called as plutonic rocks. Next, one important point we have to remember about plutonic rocks is these rocks are formed by the cooling of magma, which is a very very slow process, and these rocks will possess generally a very coarse grained crystalline structure. Okay, they are not of porous structure, they are of crystalline structure. And igneous rocks are generally used in building construction purposes, and also which is the plutonic type. And the best example what you can see in your daily life regarding this plutonic igneous rock is granite. Next, the second subclassification in igneous rocks is the hyperbasalt rocks. So what are hyperbasalt rocks? Hyperbasalt rocks are also a form of igneous rocks which are formed by the cooling of magma at relatively shallow depth from the earth's surface. Means earth surface, somewhere deeper from the earth surface, the cooling of the magma takes place and rock formation takes place. So that is called as hyperbasalt rocks. Okay, and one point we have to remember is as we are going deeper into the earth surface from the top surface, means from the crust level, when you're going deeper, one thing we have to remember is the temperature will keep on increasing. Means whatever the cooling is happening at a lower depth from the earth's surface will be very very fast, very quick. And these rocks will always possess fine grained crystalline structure since they are cooling down at shallow depths. And the best example of such type of hypervessel igneous rock is dolerite, what you can see in the diagram here. Next, coming to volcanic rocks. As the word itself it is telling, volcanic means, you know, volcano, right? So where does a volcano generally erupt? It will erupt on the earth's surface. So the rocks which are formed due to the cooling of magma or lava on the earth's surface are called volcanic rocks. Okay, so see here, basalt is a good example of volcanic rock, and the cooling is very, very rapid when compared to the other two rocks, and we get extremely fine-grained particles or texture of rocks by cooling of magma on the earth's surface. Okay, this is about volcanic rocks. Let's go into the second class, geological classification, which is sedimentary rocks. As I've told you, these rocks are formed by deposition or by sedimentation from the pre-existing rocks. Means they will be born at some place and they will be sedimented at some other place. Now, for example, let's take the example of volcanic rock. Now, the volcano has erupted on the earth's surface and the lava got cooled down and your volcanic rock formed due to weathering process. Weathering means nothing but it is a process of disintegration of rocks, decomposition of rocks. So during the due to this weathering process, what will happen is the rocks will get disintegrated, they get divided, they get split up. And what will happen? You have agents of weathering, right? Or what are these agents of weathering or agents of transport? Examples are rain, wind, flowing water, etc. So now what happened is our volcanic rock divided into some pieces due to weathering process, and now these pieces will be carried away by the agents of transport like your rain, frost, wind, etc. So when they are carried away, now that piece of stone is not at all at its place of origin. It is no more with its parent rock. It is traveling away, and when it's traveling with these agents, obviously its composition will change. All through where it is traveling, its composition will start changing, and it will be going and deposited somewhere else. So that's called sedimentary rocks. And we have four types of sedimentary rocks. First one is residual. Residual means even though weathering takes place, little portion of the product of weathering means once the rock is divided into few pieces, little pieces still remain at that place only. Even though they are affected by weathering process and even though they are affected by rain, some particles still remain at the place of origin. So that is residual. Next is sedimentary, means as I've told you, they are carried away. They are deposited at some other place. They are no more at the place of their origin. Next is chemical deposits. Chemical deposit means some stones or rocks, they are carried away in solution and they may be subjected to some physiochemical changes, like they may be affected by evaporation, they may be affected by rainfall, etc. And hence, that deposit, whatever you get, the sedimentation deposit, whatever you get is called chemical deposit. And we have the last one, which is organic deposit. So some portion of the rocks, which are formed by weathering, they get deposited by the agency of organisms. Means some organisms like ants, bacteria, change the position of the stones. That can be called as an example of organic deposits. So we can see the best example of sedimentary rocks are limestone, gypsum, gravel, etc., lignite, coal, whatever you see in your daily lives. Coming to metamorphic rocks. What are metamorphic rocks? I already told you, metamorphic rocks are derived from the word called metamorphism. Metamorphism means changing the character, changing in behavior. So metamorphic rock could be either igneous rock or a sedimentary rock which has changed its character, changed its nature, changed its composition due to heat and pressure. And we have four types of metamorphism which we assume to take place in the sedimentary or igneous rocks, and thus leading to the formation of metamorphic rocks. And generally the main agents what we consider to change the character of a given rock, to change the when igneous or sedimentary rock leading it to the formation of metamorphic rock, is heat, uniform pressure and directed pressure. So we consider these three agents which are responsible for metamorphism. Heat, you know, heat and uniform pressure means uniform pressure in all directions. Directed pressure means non-uniform pressure. Again, in metamorphic rocks, I told you we have four types. First one is thermal metamorphism, means completely the metamorphism takes place only because of heat. Next is cataclysmic metamorphism. In this type of metamorphism, what will happen is the temperatures are a little bit lesser on the surface of the earth or nearby the surface of the earth, and the changing in character or composition is due to directed pressure, means non-uniform pressure. Next we have dynamo thermal metamorphism. What is this metamorphism is? In this we have a rise in temperature, means the metamorphism, the composition of the rock will change to very much increase in temperature, and also there is a combination of temperature along with stress which makes the changes in this type of rocks, and these are generally observed when you are going deeper into the earth's surface. When we are going deeper, when you are digging inside the earth, the temperature is more, the heat is more. So along with it, stress is also more. So there you can find such type of thermal, dynamo thermal metamorphic rocks. Last one is plutonic metamorphism. The metamorphism takes place at very greater depths, but it is due to the metamorphism, whatever is taking place at the greater depths, means very deep from the earth's surface, is due to uniform pressure and heat, means the pressure around the rock is all uniform in all directions, and also heat is affecting. Clear? This is all about metamorphic rocks. So best examples of metamorphic rocks are marble, quartzite and slates. Next comes physical classification of rocks. So according to physical classification, rocks are classified into three types: stratified, unstratified and foliated rocks. So now let's get into detail what are these. So coming to first one, which is stratified rocks. Stratified rocks are those rocks which possess planes of stratification. Means, what is the meaning of plane of stratification? Means along these planes you can easily cut the stones. Okay, so these stratified rocks may have planes of stratification or planes of cleavage, either in horizontal direction or vertical direction or inclined direction, I mean the diagonal direction, any direction, but you can easily cut the stone in that direction or that rock in that direction. So they are called stratified rocks, and all sedimentary rocks can be taken as examples of stratified rocks. Second one is unstratified. So when I'm saying stratified rocks can be cut easily along the planes of stratification, means what will be unstratified rocks? They cannot be cut along the planes of stratification. Means the meaning is they don't possess any plane of stratification. They are very compact in nature. They are very dense in nature. They are close together. For example, you observe granite stone, how it looks. Can you cut granite stone in any direction? No, it is very dense in nature, very compact in nature. So all the igneous rocks which are of volcanic origin and sedimentary rocks which are affected by earthquake effects or movements of earth can be taken examples of unstratified rocks. So as I was quoting the example of granite, granite is an igneous rock. Next comes foliated rocks. Foliated rocks means these rocks will have a tendency to be split up in only one direction. You can cut these stones only in single direction. Examples are metamorphic rocks. So I'll show you some figures. So see here, stratified rocks, they are possessing planes of stratification, so you can easily cut them along the horizontal direction. Observe, it's very clear. Then you have unstratified, which cannot be cut. Granites like that, you have to quarry them. Even not only quarrying, you cannot cut it particular direction. Just you can cut the boundaries, but inside you cannot cut it very clearly. Foliated, you can cut along only one direction, means either horizontal direction or vertical direction. Last one is chemical classification of rocks. We have three types again: siliceous, argillaceous and calcareous. What are siliceous rocks? Siliceous rocks are those which have silica as major part in it. Means the percentage of silica is predominant. The percentage of silica in such types of rocks is a lot. And best example of siliceous rocks are granites, quartzites, etc. You know quartzite, right? Quartz, what we use in our watches. So it is rich in silica. So one important point about siliceous rocks is they are very hard and durable. That is why you observe for most of the construction purposes we use granites also. Next is argillaceous rocks. Argillaceous rocks are those in which clay or alumina is predominant. Means major part of the rock is composed of alumina. And these rocks are very dense in nature. Means they are very compact and all the particles are very closer to each other. Best examples of argillaceous rocks are slates, laterites. Last one is calcareous rocks. Calcareous rocks are those rocks in which calcium carbonate is predominant. And best example of stones having lot of amount of calcium carbonate is your limestone and your marble. Limestones are having good amount of, or most major amount of, calcium carbonate. And you know, limestone is one of the raw material used for manufacture of cement. And durability of these rocks will depend upon the constraint. So whatever the composition of the rock is having, the durability of that depends upon that composition. Okay, so we have an easy method to remember these. So siliceous rocks means the first letter is S, right? So siliceous means, remember, silica is predominant. Next, argillaceous, A. A, you have argillaceous word starting with A, means in this clay or alumina, you remember argillaceous alumina is predominant. Next, calcareous, C. So calcium is predominant. So remember like this. So this is, you can see the figures. This is calcareous, this is argillaceous, and this is siliceous. Okay, so that's all about classification of rocks. Hope you understood the video. Thank you.